It is so vital to any quick run, the loser must rely on a combination of strength and technique. Here's Jeff with Carl Rupke to show us what's involved.
The start's critical, and for a racer to get a good time, it's essential that he have a very good start. There's three things to look for in the start. There's the compression stroke, which starts all the way out, and the racer comes all the way down, extending himself as far as possible. That's followed by the strong pulling motion, and finally it's finished with a push off the handles.
And although a good start requires excellent upper body strength, brute force alone is not enough. The pull-push stroke must be perfectly synchronized with a quick forward thrust of the hips. And like tennis or golf, it takes years of practice to perfect your timing. Once off the handles, the racer will paddle with his spike gloves, gaining speed with each stroke. The paddle can also be used to straighten the sled out after an uneven start. And concentration must be at its peak. A weak compression stroke, an uneven push off the handles, a missed paddle, or a rough transition to the racing position can be disastrous, because a tenth of a second lost at the start will multiply to 0.4 seconds lost at the finish. And the perfect start requires all these elements to come together in smooth, powerful harmony. No one does it quite as well as Paul Hildgartner of Italy.
Paul Hildgartner now settling himself on his sled, about to have his run down this slope. It's just been freshly swept, but Jeff, the snow is coming down with such intensity that it may be anything but clear for him by the time he reaches the bottom.
That's absolutely true, Sam. And some of the athletes have told me that they're not pleased with the way the track crew has been cleaning it. That surprises me in an Olympic competition. Paul had his typical great start. He just flies right out of there, Sam. It's really impressive. Every time I watch him, I'm just astounded.
You know, the sounds that we hear, Jeff, I mean, do you, as you're going down the run, do you hear the crowd? Do you hear the ice and the steel runners? What do you hear?
I was always very aware of the sound around me. I always heard the crowd. I always was aware of the sound the sled was making. It's sensory overload, and what you're seeing, what you're feeling, what you're hearing.
Okay, the upper split time was good, but the middle split time is a lot better. Paul Hildgartner is now working on a fast run. He is coming down. He's in the labyrinth now. He had a little bit slow start, but he's made up that ground in the middle. He's coming into the finish turn in heavy snow. Paul Hildgartner, and he moves up into second place. A magnificent run for Paul Hildgartner. It leaves only Torsten Gerlitzer ahead of him. He has moved ahead of Michael Walter, Valerie Dudin, Paul Hildgartner in the outrun now. Obviously, probably very aware. No, he shook his head. He might have hoped to take the lead, but it seems to me, under the circumstances, Jeff, that was a very, very good run. Now, back at the top of the hill, Frank Masley, the top American slider in the men's division after the first run, 23 years old, Newark, Delaware, a mask of concentration right now.
And Sam, although Frank is in 15th place after the first run, his first run was very good for him. He's only 0.7 off the lead. His start didn't look terrific right there, though, I'm sorry to say. He had a little bit of a glitch in it, went a little bit off to the left side. But he looked smooth up top here. Again, you can see his position. Very good, very good.
All right, well, we'll be watching for the split time there to see how costly that may have been. Best time, of course, at the top, Janelin's time. Not bad, really. An excellent top time for Frank Masley, given his level of experience.
A little bit rough there going from straightaway at him. He dropped a foot, got a little bit crooked, but he came back.
He's enormously fit. Here is a true athlete.
Frank is a phenomenal athlete. He's got a tremendous physique. He really works hard at it.
All right, he's through and down. Well, 14th, he's moved up a position from yesterday. There are more competitors still to go, but that is an encouraging run, I think, for Frank. He will not be disappointed with that.
He did not have the luck of the draw on the sweep, on the sweeping of the track. He was the third rider we've seen since the track was swept, and there's probably a little more snow in there than he would have liked, Sam.
Well, at the end of the second run in the men's luge competition, we have a new leader, East Germany's Torsten Gerlitzer, a dark horse coming into this event. He's now ahead of the veteran Italian Paul Hildgartner, while another East German, Michael Walter, has moved from fourth to third. The big story, however, is Sergei Danilin of the Soviet Union. Eighth after the first run, he's now surged to fourth. He sees his medal hopes rekindled. Also advancing in the standings was America's Frank Masley, up from 15th place to 14th.
Okay, that was the luge for today, and of course they still have more runs to come, as Sam Posey indicated to you. These Olympics are hardly underway, but they are underway now. If you don't count the hockey games played the day before the opening ceremonies, this is only the second day of competition. Most of the things still in their early stages, like the luge and the bobsled. The figure skating hardly gotten underway. The alpine skiing hasn't started at all. As for medals, if you want to talk about those, well, the Soviet Union has six already, and they're trying to close in and pass Norway as the all-time leader in Winter Olympics medals. They trailed by 11 when the games began. Now they just trailed them by six medals, and they only started in the Winter Olympics in 1952, you know. Well, we're going to be back with much, much more here. First, an ABC News brief and that word from your local stations.